Father God, we do thank you right now for CMA. We thank you for the vision that you've given them. Lord, we thank you for the servants that go out into the highways and byways. Lord, we thank you for those you're bringing in right now. Lord, I just pray, and we're all in agreement that you're going to touch them through the music and through what we learned today about what you're doing through these servants. Lord, I pray everybody in here has an open heart and can feel your presence already, let alone what you're going to show us through what we're going to hear through them and through the music. It's in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Amen.
have been given all authority in heaven and on earth. Therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Teach these new disciples to obey all the commands I have given you. And be assured of this, I am with you always, even to the end of the age.
Go into all the world. How is that possible? No person, no church, no organization can do that alone. And yet Jesus was very clear in this command. Only by working together and contributing as we are able will we complete the task. In CMA, we understand that we must do our part. We're not a fundraising organization. Run for the Sun is the only official fundraising effort we're involved in, and we give away more than we keep. None of the money raised is used to fund the day-to-day operating expenses of CMA or any other organization. CMA keeps 40%, which we use to reach out to bikers and others throughout the United States and around the world. We go places where others don't or won't go. We reach out in service and look for opportunities to let our light shine. We strive to demonstrate the unconditional love of Christ. Every year, CMA members represent Christ to more than 2 million people, exposing more than 500,000 to the gospel message, with approximately 14,000 of those making the life-changing decision to accept Jesus as their personal Savior. 20% of the money raised is used to support the work of the Jesus Film Project. The Jesus Film has been translated into more than 1,300 languages and shown in more than 200 countries. Historically, for every dollar CMA invests in the Jesus Film, approximately 10 people see the film somewhere in the world and at least one accepts Christ. Using these estimates, the support provided through Run for the Sun has allowed approximately 110 million people to view the film, with some 11 million of those making decisions for Christ. These decisions are a direct result of CMA's Run for the Sun. 20% of the total raised is used to support Missionary Ventures International, where CMA has placed more than 6,500 bicycles, 5,500 motorcycles, plus boats, horses, buggies, snowmobiles, and at least one camel to pastors working in more than 100 countries. Right now, there are more than 12,000 pastors, evangelists, teachers, and Christian leaders equipped with efficient transportation, doing their part to fulfill the Great Commission because of CMA's Run for the Sun. 20% goes to Open Doors, supporting their effort to promote the gospel in countries where being a Christian can get you locked up or killed. One of the greatest challenges to Christians living under tyranny and loss of religious freedom is isolation from God's Word and from the body of Christ. Through Open Doors, CMA supports and strengthens suffering believers by providing Bibles and gospel development resources, by supporting the advancement of women and children, and through Christian community restoration efforts. CMA's Run for the Sun is a place where you can invest and know that you'll be participating in something that will result in someone's life being changed. On the first Saturday in May, CMA members across the United States will participate in Run for the Sun. You can touch someone somewhere in the world for Christ, but the choice is yours. Will you support CMA's Run for the Sun?
Is now. Can you all hear me? Kind of hard to follow that up. What I'm going to do before we really get started, I'm going to introduce everybody that came with us today. Of course, most of you know me. I'm Mark George. I'm the local president of Christian Motorcycle Association, the Clean Chapter, Warriors of the Way. Soldier, why don't you stand up so they can see you?
I don't want to block you.
Go ahead.
No, that's okay. It's not about me. Hello, everybody. My name is Soldier for the Lord, legally, birth certificate, driver's license, everything from 2002. While I was an active duty Army, and they thought it was such a big deal, they put me in the newspaper, and then they made me a chaplain assistant and everything else. And the testimony for that was I was being persecuted for some things in the Army. You know how you don't drink coffee with the right group and all this other stuff like that, don't smoke cigarettes and all that stuff like that. Well, I asked the Lord Why are they after me? All I want to do is do my job and retire. And the Lord the Lord said, it's not you, it's what's inside you that they're after. So to this day, I don't know why I did this, but Soldier for the Lord is my internet name. And I said, I'm going to show them, I'm going to change my name to Soldier for the Lord. And I did legally. Of course, it got worse once you testify and everything else like that. But look at me now. You know, I am retired, you know, and blessed and everything else and stuff with my disability and everything else like that. And now I can be a soldier for the Lord for the CMA and everybody else. You know, my ministry is called Next Level Ministry. And if I can help you get to the next level, that's not only going to bless you, it's going to bless me, too. Thank you.
Thanks, soldier. This is Andrew, our road captain. Go ahead and stand up, Andrew. They can't see you.
I've been with CMA for, about 3 years?
About 3 years, yeah.
And the Lord has strengthened me and moved me ways that I wouldn't have gone without him. I've gone to rallies. And for me to get up and talk to people is a big thing.
Tell them what your nickname is.
Mark calls me Teller.
You know Penn and Teller, the quiet guy?
Yeah. Thanks, Andrew. Hallelujah. All right, Tim.
Hi, my name's Tim. I'm actually one of the newer members. About 6 months. So nice to meet you guys.
I'm good.
I'm Anthony. Anthony from Fort Hood, Clean area, about 20 years now. I'm an Army brat and also a dirtbag. And I call myself a dirtbag because we are all created from dirt by God. And I wear that with honor. And I ride with a group of guys from work who believe in Christ as I do. And we don't mind getting dirty on a bike, so dirtbag stuck with it. I ran into this dirtbag a few weeks ago, brother in Christ. Me and my son were coming home from Belton, and we were on the bike, and we stopped in at Whataburger, where we weren't going to stop in Harker Heights. We don't normally stop in Harker Heights, Whataburger. I was going to go to actually Tremere, where we met this morning. But something told me, my stomach maybe, and we pulled over in there, and I met Mark and Ham, right?
Joel.
Yogi. Cool guy, Garrett. You know, he's trying to eat everybody's food. Great guys. We hit it off right away, and we shared a bond of riding and fellowship, and they invited me to come out to this today, me and my son, and prayed for us in the parking lot over my bike. Which to me, I've never had that done before. I grew up in the CMA, actually, many years ago. My dad was in the CMA. He's moved on to Alabama now, and he recently sold off his bike. But I remember the love and the brotherhood that the CMA provided for my father and for our family, and he showed it. He showed it to me. And me and my son in the Whataburger in Killeen, we prayed, and he showed me that love. And so when he threw me this invite, I was more than honored to join him today and y'all. And I want to thank you all very much for having me. And it's been a blessing. It's been a long journey. And I'm looking forward to see what God does.
Amen. I don't know if I can follow that. That's pretty good. Who wants to go riding after that one video, huh?
So I've been with the CMA for about 3 years now. I've actually had the opportunity to go across country. I've been serving in the Army for 18 and a half years, so a year and a half, and then I'll be retired. Woo-hoo! But 9 months ago, the Lord decided that I needed to move to Maryland. And before I even moved to Maryland, and it was only for 9 months, but before I needed moved to Maryland, I was already a member of CMA here in Texas. I contacted the CMA chapter out there. I knew everybody in the chapter before I got there. When my family got there, we were welcomed with open arms. There was a time where I was training in New Jersey, and my wife was visiting Busch Gardens, or headed down to Busch Gardens with our four kids. And the van broke down. Now I'm in New Jersey. She's at Busch Gardens. We don't know anybody. So I called the CMA president in the chapter that I was with in Maryland, and they contacted somebody down there. And that matter of fact, it was the area rep went down there and fixed the van for free for and saved them for saved me a lot of money. But yeah, I mean, CMA is awesome. I met Mark 3 years ago at Sam's in Harker Heights, and at the time, I just bought a motorcycle. Didn't know what motorcycle club or association I wanted to join. I had combat vets that was trying to get me in their association. You know, I prayed about it, and then lo and behold, I run into Sam and Joel at Sam's Club. And my four-year-old now, he was two.
He's two.
Yeah, so he's almost five. Was running after him around Sam's Club. So that was the Lord just running with him. So thank you for having me here, though.
Amen.
There's no coincidence when it comes to God. That before I get started, I'm going to go ahead and open us up with prayer. That's okay with everybody. Father God, I just thank you for this beautiful day that you've given us and this amazing opportunity to come here and stand in front of these awesome people, this home church, Lord, that holds dear, near and dear to my heart. Father, I get to do a couple things that I love the most. And one of them is ride motorcycle, and two is to talk about you. Father, take me out of the way and replace my words with yours. And I just pray for an anointing. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right. As the video showed, Run for the Sun, that's our main fundraiser. That's our only fundraiser. And what that does is that all that money goes out. Because not everybody's equipped to go to Syria. Not everybody's equipped to go to North Korea or some of these other countries. Not everybody's equipped to show the Jesus film in remote areas or bring a motorcycle on a small little boat that can barely support it to some country in South America. So what we do is we support all these things. We support with our prayers and with our wallets. And so I know talking about money in a church, you know, a lot of people get kind of upset about that. But that's the reality of ministry. These motorcycles, these camels and horses and all that stuff aren't going to buy themselves. The Jesus film has been doing amazing things. It's right in my heart. Open Doors Ministry is in over 60 different countries. They're like the special operations of the missions fields. They go in places like Syria where we're bombing, where other people are bombing, where they're bombing themselves. And instead of bullets and bombs, they're armed with Bibles, and they're in the local language in every country that they're in, whether it's North Korea, whether it's Syria, Egypt, Iraq, you name it, they're there. And so with that, there's over 100 million Christians in the world that are being persecuted or that are in countries where they get persecuted. I don't know if you've seen in the news where Egypt, the Coptic Christians are getting massacred. This is some of the places that we're reaching. This is some of the places that Open Doors goes to. Since we started supporting Open Doors Ministries, we've donated over $13.3 million, million with a capital M. They've been able to distribute over 2.6 million Bibles. Million Bibles, right? And we get reports. I get reports because I know some missionaries that are in some very Muslim-heavy countries, and I can't really tell you where they are because it'll blow their cover. But these guys are doing it. These guys are out there doing what the Great Commission is, and that's go out and tell people about Jesus. And with that partnership is the Jesus Film Project. Man, it's just like, oh, Jesus Film. Yeah, they show the movie and stuff. No, it's much more than that. It's much more than that. They've gotten creative over the last several years. They've gotten very And I can't say about some of their methods because it's, you know, we'd blow their cover. And because I know that this goes out there and there's people from overseas that watch it. And they're like, oh, that's why I get free Wi-Fi. You know, stuff like that. But the Jesus film is in over 1,420 different languages. That's a lot of languages. How many people knew that there's that many languages in the world? I sure didn't. I know there's a lot, but and every year they add more and more. And it's been shown to a worldwide audience. Can anybody guess? Thousands? Hundreds? Thousands? Millions? No, how about billions? Billions with a capital B, right? Wow, that's a lot of people. That's doing it. And there's people called to do that. And there's people that not everybody's able-bodied to do that. For every dollar invested, at least 10 people worldwide see the Jesus film. And that's, you know, I hate to put a dollar amount on that, but that's a tangible thought in your head, you know, that even if I gave a dollar today, that means that 10 people can learn about Jesus. Isn't that cool? Isn't that just amazing? I mean, can you even think about that? Can you even fathom that, man, I only have a dollar today, or I only have some change, or maybe some pocket lint, you know? But every bit of it goes out there, every bit of it. And then the prayers do amazing, you know? And so since we started supporting the Jesus film, we've given out almost $12 million to support them. So all that money goes out there. All that money, we don't hold on to it. We don't keep it. We don't. As soon as we get it to them. We write them the check, and there it is. And that's why we do this. We do it year-round, but it accumulates in the first Saturday of May. So I don't want to hog the other ones because we got Missionary Ventures as well as the money that stays here in the United States and helps us do our mission, because I'm going to let Jason and Andrew tell about that. But I'm going to also tell about some of the miracles that have gone on since I've been in CMA. Some of the things I've seen, I'm a frequent flyer up at the ICU up in Scott and White. And second floor, I have seen so many miracles. So many miracles. And matter of fact, Dustin can tell you about a miracle we were just talking about earlier. My little escapades at Pluckers, where I had to be resuscitated. I had a mass, and it was bad. It was called retroperitoneal fibrosis, a very rare thing, but it's a very dangerous thing. And right there at Pluckers, instead of paying my bill, I decided to check out for a few minutes. And but you know, it's funny is, we laugh about it now. Dustin paid the bill, by the way. We laugh about it now, but your heart stops one time. You never always get reminded of it. But anyway, we had our waiter was a combat medic, and there's what, six nurses, and then I had this huge watch, right, that my wife got Avon. And this one nurse was trying to take my pulse and says, anybody got a watch? And it was the same arm that I had that huge watch on. But anyway, a little more than a year ago. Now, see, mind you, nobody's ever been cured of this. Nobody's ever, you know, never. I mean, they do, like, stuff that's chemotherapy. They try to chisel it out because it's calcified mass and all that. But anyway, a year ago, about January of last year, my doctor at the VA calls me and says, hey, when can you come in? And usually that's not good. You know, usually when they call you right after you had a scan and say, I need you to come in immediately, it's not good. Well, she said, as soon as I got there, she's like, first of all, it's not bad news. So there goes some sweats, but then she holds up the scans. And I see the mass. And then the one from the September before, it's kind of blurry. You can't see it. Of course, there's no contrast. And then the one I used the contrast, it's gone. It's just completely gone. you know. And a lot of times when you have a mass, when you have something, your body kind of works around it, and there's some scar tissue, and you see where things moved. No, it's like it was never there. So, and that's because I had people like Monty praying for me, Dustin praying for me, and I had so many people praying for me so often that, you know, like people say, man, God doesn't answer prayers no more. You know, I mean, I can tell you he does. And so that's where, you know, so, okay, Mark, what's the point? If you can't give, you can pray. And prayer is the most powerful weapon you can use. There ain't no bomb. There ain't no bullet. There's no weapon that can beat the power of prayer. So without further, I'm going to go ahead and hand it over to Jason. And he's going to tell you about missionary ventures. It's right there.
All right, I get the mic again. Uh-oh. All right, so one of the ministries the CMA partners with is Missionary Ventures. And when I first heard about it, I was like, well, what is Missionary Ventures? So I went online and I was watching that video, and then I saw the camel. And I was like, they donated a camel? But if you think about it, so Missionary Ventures, they partner with pastors all around the world. Now, some people here in the United States think about that, and they're like, okay, they donate motorcycles. Well, I'll say modes of transportation, because the camel was involved in that. A lot of people in the United States don't realize that in these other countries, just the terrain that these pastors have to go over, the mountains, you know. And if you think about it, 2,000 years ago, when Jesus and his disciples walked the earth, how long did it take them to get from town to town to spread the message? And don't laugh at me, but sometimes I picture Jesus and his disciples on some motorcycles. Amen. And thinking how much more, and the more people they could have witnessed to, and the more information we would have had, you know, where nobody could deny the Bible. There would be no proof to deny it. But you got those skeptics out there. So what Missionary Ventures does is, like I said, they partner up with the pastors, and this is the numbers have definitely rose, but they've donated 6,500 bicycles, 5,700 motorcycles, 28 boats, 31 horses, 3 horse and buggies, 2 snowmobiles, and 1 camel. And they're working in 105 different countries, these pastors. Over the past 29 years, the Run for the Sun has donated $13.2 million to Missionary Ventures through Run for the Sun. And typically, these pastors that get these motorcycles, not only are they with a church over here where they're ministering to individuals, when they get the motorcycle, they go out and they plant churches. So within the first year a pastor gets a motorcycle, they see at least 100 people come to Christ at their new church that they planted. So, yeah, it's amazing. And, you know, they can't do it on their own. They need the donations from Run for the Sun. And that's why we do this once a year, where this is our only fundraiser. And I'm very passionate about Missionary Ventures. Well, all of them. So thank you for listening, and I'll pass it over to Andrew. Amen. You want me to stay up here with you?
I'm good.
You sure?
Yep.
Okay.
You got this, man. All right, so the 40% that stays in the United States, it helps us supply all the Bibles that we give out. These Bibles are the New Testament, but they also give testimonies from people that have been in jail. It gives all kinds of different testimonies of bikers. It also supplies us with coffee cups that have scripture on them, that people just come get coffee and then they read the scripture. The rag tracts that we give out have scripture on it. Just everything that we give out has scripture on it. And just by looking at it, they get scripture. People come to Christ just because of stuff we give out. And if we didn't give stuff out, who would come talk to us? Amen. Mark.
Thanks, Andrew. Short and to the point. I love it. As you can see, Run for the Sun has many different facets of it. And like Andrew was saying, the 40% that stays here helps us do our job, whether we go to Sturgis, Route Rally, Lone Star, or wherever else we go. It gives us the kickstand coasters, the Bibles, different tracks, and as well as the rag tracks that a lot of people are familiar with. Each year we get our chapter, because I'm not ashamed to do a big wish list. Some people are a little bashful by it, but I'm not. And we get about $500 to $600 worth of items that otherwise our chapter would have to fork out the money and pay for. So that helps us do our thing and operate on minimal costs. So what we're going to do is we're going to play another video, and then we're going to pass the collection. Monty's coming up here. Am I in trouble? Oh, okay. Yeah, Monty, come on up, and we'll pray before we show the video. I knew it.
This last video is called Thank You. It's powerful. Still a tearjerker, I suppose. I didn't watch it, but it's hard for me to get through it without crying. It's really powerful. The little girl's still there? Anyway, we're going to pray, and then we're going to pass the basket around during this video. And again, after the video, we'll close in prayer and send our brothers off in Christ. We're all in this for Jesus Christ, aren't we? Amen. Father God, we do thank you again for the vision you've given CMA. Oh, Lord, all started because one man wanted to reach his son. You didn't have a clue. You were in it all along. Lord, I just ask right now that you would bless this blessing that we're about to take up. Just knowing that out of every $5, there's one salvation guaranteed, has been for years, so powerful. Lord, let us, as we watch this video and we give, feel your holy presence. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
The crystal sea, we heard the angels singing, and someone called your name. We turned and saw this young man, and he was smiling as he came. And he said, "Friend, you may not know me now." And then he said, "But wait. You used to teach my Sunday school when I was only 8. And every week you would say a prayer before the class would start. And one day when you said that prayer, I asked Jesus in my heart. Thank you for giving to so glad you came. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord.
We're going to close with prayer. It's a special prayer. Did you have it? That was it, wasn't it? Did you have some? Okay. But what I want to do is I want to bring my CMA brothers up here. We're going to surround them, and we're going to pray over them. That will be our closing prayer. After that, we'll go across the street here in a few minutes. Y'all just get real tight. Go ahead and love your neighbors. And then we're going to surround you guys, and we're going to pray over you. Amen. And, glory. All you blood-bought saints that can't reach him, you can just reach your hands forward or touch the person in front of you. Whew. The power of prayer, right, brother? Glory. Father God, right now we just thank you again for your servants. Lord, we ask for a hedge of protection around them always. Lord, let everyone that they come in contact with see you in them. Lord, we ask you to send the Spirit ahead of them. Prepare the hearts of those that they don't even know you've set up a divine appointment for. Lord, give them the divine wisdom to recognize that appointment and then the courage to step out of that comfort zone and speak the truth. Speak of you. Speak of what you've done in their lives. Each and every one of them here have testimonies. Lord, let them be open to share that with those that they see in this lost, dark, and perverse world. Keep them safe until you bring them back in your speed, Lord. Allow us to continue to lift each other up in prayer, for we're all here for the same reason. That is to lift up you and only you. It's in Jesus' mighty name we pray. And all his children said, amen. Amen. Glory to God.